So following on from the previous video, this time we've still got our contactor, although we've called it a 20 amp contactor, still the same configuration as previous. We have a much heavier lighting load, so I've just said it's 12 amps, so this could be a bank of fluorescent lights or something. And this time we also have two circuit breakers. So again, let's put our neutral connections in. We've got our neutral going to there. We have our neutral going to A2 of the coil. And we also have our neutral going to the lights. So what we have is a live feed that comes directly across to the PIR. And we have a live feed from the other circuit breaker that goes to the contactor. Now, remember, these are still single phase, but they are two circuit breakers that are operating basically the same circuit. So care must be taken or things need to be considered there. So we'll just follow this on. Again, we're just going to take a feed from the other side of the contactor. That's going to go straight to the lights. And then we have our other feed coming from the PIR. And then that is going to go to the contactor. So let's just run through how this is now going to work. So we have our 6 amp feed coming through to the PIR. So again, it's a permanent live position, a permanent live connection at the PIR. We then have from the switch outlet of the PIR, that comes down to feed the coil. We then have our circuit breaker, a permanent live feed, feeding the coil here, and then feed in the bank of lights. Now, let's just talk about the circuit breakers. The 6 amp circuit breaker only needs to be a B-type circuit breaker. The other circuit breaker, and I've said a 20 amp circuit breaker, but it might only be a 16 amp, that might be recommended to be a C-type, dependent on what the load is. Now, if it's a fluorescent lighting load, then it's probably important that it's a C-type. If they're modern day LEDs, they're not necessarily going to be drawing any heavy load, but they do have some, with the LED lighting circuits, they do have some funny things happening with inrush currents. So again, consideration there for a C-type breaker may also be needed, even if they are LEDs, even if the load is very, very small. So let's just talk through the operation of the circuit here. So again, we've got our permanent live feed here. So if someone is detected, or if this detects something, this will close. So the circuit now is going through to the coil, through to A terminal A1. It pulls this down. It will make connection here, which then brings the full load coming through to the lights, and the lights will illuminate. Now, it's really important to, if you're going to be doing this, it's really important to have the board labelled up correctly. And it would be my recommendation that both of these circuit breakers would be next to each other in the board. And it needs to be labelled very clearly that these are both for the same circuit. Now, it doesn't really matter with the PIR. If the PIR is going to be changed or worked on in the future, you only need to turn this one circuit breaker off. But let's say we're going to be working on the contactor and we're going to replace the contactor, and we haven't got the board labelled up very well, you might just turn this circuit breaker off. So you're getting rid of the feed here, and you could be working on this, and then something could trigger the PIR, which then will operate the coil. And so suddenly this is being worked on and it now becomes live. So a big consideration needs to be that if you are working on the contactor side of things, both of these would need to be safely isolated. And on the actual contactor, I would also have a label saying more than one circuit feeding this this contactor. So the beauty with this circuit, you've got a very heavy load here. None of that load is going through the PIR. It's all going through the contactor, and the circuit will work nicely.